Hello to all my friends out there. If you can believe it, it's really, really hot here. It's like 11 o'clock at night and it's still hot. Okay, this is another carnivore meal. And what happened was I was following Sid Off the Grid, and I'm really glad I am too. And you guys want to check that channel out. I love her channel. I think I first noticed it because of her mom. So hi to Sid's mom. So okay, I thought, well, you know, Sid's food looks so good, you know? So I started researching the carnivore diet, and it's easy enough, it's all meat. And I thought, wow, it looks so good. So what happened was I had about 3 carnivore meals in a row, and I mean, you don't get hungry when you're on the carnivore diet. Not at all. So I hope everyone is doing good. I'm going to drink some Diet Coke with my carnivore meal. Because Diet Coke tastes really, really good with meat. So back here by my candle, I drew a little mantis bean because, you know, as soon as my meal is over, I'm going to have a little chat on mantis. Okay, now, if you are the type that cannot stand the thought of an alien, you can tune out, just stop watching at that point. I didn't like the rude woman, so I decided to control the videos a little bit more when it's a subject that might go out of control, because I do not believe that this person has self-control to control herself or himself. So what will happen is if they don't, I will delete their comments or report them as a hater. You know, I will take care of it. So I have some tasty hot wings. Okay, I bought all this meat cheap at Albertsons on markdown. The wings were already seasoned, so you don't have to season them. You just put them in some oil and bake them, $3.50. I even cooked the little wing things. I'll eat them. So these cost me, they were $10 marked down to $7, so $3.50. These were marked down to $3, so that's $1. So we have $4.50. And then I fried a tasty little steak. The steak was actually pretty cheap. The steak was $5, so marked down $1.50. So $3.50, so $1.75 for the steak. The hot wings were actually the most expensive. $3.50. So about $5, $6. And then at Dollar Tree, I bought some steak sauce. My beans are not done. They're taking forever. And I like meat, this meat on a cutting board. If I could, I'd throw the bones over my shoulder. And then I still have cookies left, if you can believe it. And I eat them at will, you know. I eat as many as I want. See, I've gone through quite a few. I think there was 2 dozen. These are good, Albertsons. Oh, one of my cookies is cracked. I hate that. But, you know, if you consider that I paid 99 cents for all these cookies, no complaining. And for my hot dogs, I like, where is it? Mustard on my hot dogs and ketchup. And then I like steak sauce on my steak. So, you know, you couldn't go, here's my beans that are not done yet. I didn't have them up too high because I was gone a lot today. I was working. Okay, now let me taste this. And you know, when I eat this at night, I feel good. So I'm pretending I'm at a steakhouse. This is a steakhouse. This is my house. I don't have my steak too rare because, you know, I'm basically kind of afraid to eat rare meat these days. Too rare. Yummy. Okay. Now I'm going to start discussing the mantis. I drew this mantis. Most hairdressers are a bit artistic. You might not know that if you just go get your hair done. A lot of people don't know their hairdressers that well, and some are like best friends. Like, I always was very friendly with my clients. If they wanted to make my life miserable, I just assumed they went to someone else. Okay, now for the mantis people. So, you know, tune out if you can't handle it. Do us all a favor. Take your awful self out of here. The term insectoid denotes any creature or object that shares a similar body or traits with common earth insects and arachnids, or otherwise spiders. That is one word I did learn in Spanish. Araña. Because the beauty shop I had in had a lot of spiders in my corner. We just could not get rid of them for some reason. I hate spiders. And then this is what I do. I'm not gonna lie to you, this is what I do. But a mantis is an alien. Insectoid. Insectoid. Suffix. Denoting similar. So a mantis being is similar to a praying mantis. But it's not an insect. It's an alien. Okay. People have reported being abducted by a mantis. Beings. And when they were abducted, it seemed as if the mantis beings were the overseers on the spacecraft. So basically, mantis are like kidnappers. They didn't say, would you like to go on this space trip with us to Mars? No, they took these people. The abductees report ominous presence of the entities looming over their beds. Can you imagine when awakened out of a sleep? Now that'd be bad. Although gray figures are commonly, like gray aliens, are commonly reported by abductees, insect-like creatures are overseeing or commanding the entire operation. The mantis seem to occupy the highest positions in the chain of command. Now, have I ever seen a mantis? No, but I have had a dream of a mantis. And like, I had no idea, you know, I told myself, well, how do I come up with this stuff? It's not like I'm watching science fiction. All right, now, they stand about 9 feet tall. So they're not tiny like a fly. Walk in bipedal position, have narrow faces with long slanted eyes. Their thin, delicate torsos bring them a step closer to a praying mantis. Extremely long arms, and there's male and female. Species bug. Abilities, Immortality, superhuman, strength, durability, speed, and reflexes. Now, I did hear this by abductees that they are extremely quick. That's like, have you ever tried to kill a fly? I hate flies. The steak is good. It wasn't expensive in the first place. It got Albertsons. I bagged up my wings, the rest. There was 10. And here's the, these were marked down $3, so you got six, so 50 cents each. I thought that was pretty reasonable. Tomorrow I'll make the rest of my squash things to go with my beans if they ever get done. Okay, they're energy absorbers, manipulating, and projectors. Energy absorbers does not sound good, like absorb your energy. Ability to generate heat, cold, and antimatter, and flight. Some report being abducted to Mars. And then when they got to Mars, there was Mantis or Saturn. I think they've been reported to be on Saturn. Not sure about that, though. Anyway, but once they got there, they reported encountering Mantis. And then that resulted in attacks that resulted in either death or severed limbs. They speak in clicking sounds and they're telepathic. Okay, are mantis on Earth? Yes, I think they are on Earth. Are mantis involved in abductions? Yes, I think they are involved in abductions of humans. Are mantis on Mars or Saturn? Yes, I think so. Can mantis DNA be inserted in a human egg which has had its nucleus removed, resulting in a hybrid? I think so. You know, it's kind of interesting, but the grays look a little bit similar to a mantis. And they're involved in abductions. Can we expect these beings to show up on Earth? Yes, I think so. In fact, that's the point of a lot of these discussions, is it's possible that these beings might start showing themselves. I think they're here, but they might show up. Is an alien a demon? They can be demon-like, but they have bodies, I think. It's been reported that mantis can be invisible. Did you see the stealth looking unidentified flying object this week on Dabu 777? That looked like it could be a little bit invisible. I think they have that invisibility ability now. Are aliens up to no good? Yes, I think they are up to no good. They're up to abducting humans. And the thing is after the humans are abducted, then the humans are all messed up and they can't remember why. And then when they remember why, it was awful. They were on Mars like 20 years. And it's not, there's a lot of people coming forward saying, I have been abducted by aliens. And they report encounters with mantis. Are there sexual encounters with mantis? It has been reported, which, remember, I think it was live chat one, would you rather have a sexual encounter? Well, you're basically abducted with a mantis or a reptilian. It has been reported. I think that'd be bad. Are people forever changed by encounters with mantis? It has been reported that people who have been abducted, this my dinner is good, you guys, by mantis have been forever changed. Supposedly, they're supposed to be a little bit benevolent, but I don't think so. In fact, the question, are aliens up to no good? I would say, yeah, they're up to no good. First of all, the mantis abduct humans without their permission and keep them for 20 years and do all kinds of grisly experiments. And the reptilians are carnivorous. So how's that like our friends? Are mantis our friends? No, I don't think so. Are aliens our friends? No, I don't think so. Are demons our friends? No, I do not think they are our friends. So that is the chat on the mantis. And if you have a comment, my followers read the comments, but if you start insulting my appearance or you're just a darn troll, I will report you as a troll and I will block you, which I don't like to do. But all my followers are nice, so why should we put up with it? So I hope you guys might want to try the... This is one of my better ones. This really is. This is enough meat for 2 days. Like carnivorous. Okay, God bless you all.